Hello and welcome. I'm Matthias for MamoWorld.com, and today I show you how to use Mask Tracker Plus to stabilize a shaky clip such that it gets a nice and smooth camera movement. Before we start, I want to say thank you to the team from Pond5 for providing us the clip that we use in this example. So here we have our shaky clip in After Effects, and the first thing I need to do is to choose a region that I want to track. You usually best pick a part of the background, because this is what you want to stabilize, and you pick a part that is not overlapping with the actors or anything moving in the foreground over time. So what I can pick in this case is, for example, this part of this tree here. I set the mask mode to none and call the layer background track. And I set the tracking options that I can also reveal by right-clicking on the mask and clicking track mask, then I get to this window, and now in the tracking options I choose position, scale and rotation, because this is what I want to stabilize. Now I go to the first frame and click track forwards. As you can see, the track nicely follows our tree. The easiest thing you can do now with this track is to eliminate the tracked movement completely. For this, you select your tracked mask, and in Mask Tracker Plus, click on the Load button. Once the tracking data is loaded, you select your layer, choose the Stabilize function, and click Apply. Now, to eliminate the movement completely, you choose this second option here, and click OK. As you can see now, at the current frame, the image doesn't change, but if we play through the clip, you can see that the layer is moving such that the background stays perfectly static. You also see that by this, big transparent borders are introduced, and therefore it's usually better to just smooth the movement instead of eliminating it completely. Smoothing the movement is just as easy as eliminating it completely. I start again with the unstabilized clip, make sure that my track is loaded into Mask Tracker Plus, choose the Stabilize function, and with the background layer selected, apply it. This time I choose Smooth Movement instead of Eliminate Movement completely. If you take a look at the default result of this, you can see that the tree is now not perfectly static, but moving very smoothly in the background to follow the camera movement. Also note that Mask Tracker Plus has created a layer that is called Stabilization Controls that offers some effects to fine-tune the smoothing that just happened. You can control the smoothness separately for the position, rotation and scale. If we, for example, set the position smoothing from 100 frames to just 10 frames, you can see that the movement of the tree is much less smooth, but therefore there are also less borders visible. This makes it easy now to get exactly the amount of smoothness that you want. Also note that the tree is currently moving both left and right and up and down. If you want to eliminate the movement in one direction completely, let's say for example we want the tree to move left and right but not up and down, you can also use these log X and log Y controls. So if we set the log Y to on and play again through the clip, you can see that the tree is not moving up and down anymore, but is only moving left and right, which gives you the impression of the camera sitting on a tripod rather than moving freely in space. Similarly, you also have these lock options for rotation and scale. Mask Tracker Plus offers two options to get rid of the transparent edges at the borders that occur during the stabilization process. Here we are at a frame where this border is pretty large. We can get rid of it by using the zoom slider of the stabilization controls layer to zoom in and make our image a bit larger. You can combine this by also repositioning the layer itself, in this case by just moving it up a bit. You can see that in this case, this eliminated almost all the transparent edges, but at the bottom there are still some visible. Therefore, we move the layer down again a little bit and increase the scale even further, and now no borders are visible anymore. Obviously, often we do not want to zoom into our image, since this changes the framing of our shot. So we go back here to a scale value of 100 and also reset here the position. And I show you an alternative approach to get rid of these borders. The core idea of this approach is to reconstruct the missing parts of the frame by information that you filmed at earlier or later times. So the idea is, for example, at this frame, this part here is missing. Yeah? But if we take a look at an earlier frame, more of this information shows through, and this information didn't change really so much during this time. So what we can do here is do the following. We take our layer and duplicate it by clicking Ctrl D. And now this duplicate behind our original, we shift in time. And if we do this, you can see that depending on which time I choose, another part of the frame is covered with this missing information. If you look at this edge more closely, you can see this is what is missing in the current frame, and this is what I get when I look one frame later in time by shifting the bottom layer. If I even shift one frame or a few frames more, you can see that a reasonable information is reconstructed for this part. We still have a little bit of an edge being visible here, and we can avoid this by adding a mask to this layer. So I choose a rectangle mask and double click on it to get a mask that exactly fits our frame. And we can get rid of the track here. And now I feather this mask a little bit and hide its visibility. And we can see now with just a value of 14 in this case, there is no edge anymore and we nicely reconstructed this part. Looking at one other point in time is usually not good enough to reconstruct all the information. So you can see, for example, in this case, this other frame we look at in this layer is good enough to reconstruct the missing information here, but the missing information here is also not recovered in this frame. And if we go to other frames, it will probably be even worse. So one approach that you can do now is to say, we look at many, many points in time simultaneously. And I do this by duplicating this layer, or actually I duplicate the top one because for this one I also had the mask already. So I want to always have between the different copies such a feathered mask. I duplicate this copy and shift the lower one a little bit in time, duplicate another one, shift it a little bit in time, duplicate another one, shift, duplicate, shift, and so on. And now, for each frame, I essentially looked at a lot of later frames to reconstruct the missing borders. And now I also want to look at earlier frames, in particular for these frames that are here, because otherwise I don't have information for this. So I do the same in the opposite direction. Duplicate my layer, shift it a bit to here, duplicate, shift, and so on. Finally, I make another duplicate and move it at the very bottom. And for this bottommost one, I remove the parenting, so I parent it to none, such that it doesn't move at all and fills in all the missing parts. Obviously, for this last layer, it doesn't move with the track, so what it will fill in is not accurate, but anyway, it is just used to fill in the tiny little bits that are left, and usually this is good enough. So let me now finally increase the smoothness here again a little bit more to make the result even more obvious. And if we now take a look at this, you can see that the camera movement is pretty smooth and the borders are pretty nicely reconstructed. If you closely look at the limitations, so take a look here at this boy, you can see sometimes at the borders there are some artifacts visible. This is because the boy is really moving a lot, so taking a look at earlier and later frames in time will not give you an accurate result here. But in other places where not much is happening, like here for the tree, everything that is reconstructed at the borders, or also what is happening here, gives you really good accurate results. So, okay, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned now how to stabilize a shaky clip with the help of Mask Tracker Plus. Again, thanks a lot to the team from Pond5 for providing us this sample clip, and I'm looking forward again to see you in the next tutorial.